In this problem, we're going to learn how to convert from grams to kilograms. And the techniques that I'm going to use can be used for any type of conversion problems. This particular example is just from grams to kilograms. So step one, we need to get the conversion ratio. So in every conversion problem, you're going to have two units. You're going to have the units you start in. And for this problem, that's grams, because we can see that our number says 12,400 grams. And then we're going to convert into kilograms, just because the problem asks us to. So before we can do anything, we have to know how many grams equals how many kilograms, or how many kilograms equal how many grams. And so you can get this a couple of ways. You may have learned the metric system prefixes in your class, or maybe you're going to look it up. It doesn't matter, but however you do it, you need to somehow come to the knowledge that 1 kilogram equals 1,000 grams. So the prefix kilo means that it takes 1,000 of your base units to add up to 1 kilo of whatever you have, and for this problem we're in grams. All right, step two, write your given number, the number in the problem, as a fraction. And so we can see that our given number is 12,400. And we're going to use our math knowledge to turn it into a fraction, even though it's not written as one. So if you just have a number and it's not written as a fraction, you can always make it one by just adding a fraction bar and adding a denominator of one. This is equal to any just regular number. And no matter how your number looks, even if it's a decimal already or really small or really big, all numbers can be turned into fractions like this. And then another really important thing is that we have to also include the units in this fraction. And so grams, we can see, just looks regular. It's not clearly on the denominator, which means that it's also on the numerator. So we're gonna have to include grams in our given number fraction. All right, so that's step two. And now step three, we're gonna write the conversion ratio as a fraction and solve. So first I'm gonna bring down step two. And now I'm going to write my conversion ratio in a fraction that looks like this. And my job is to figure out what is going to go on the numerator and what's going to go on the denominator. And the equal sign in step one, that's going to turn into our fraction bar. And so now we're looking at our problem, and this is why we had to include units in our fraction. We can see that grams is in the numerator. And the whole point of this problem is to get rid of grams and cancel it out for kilograms. So the way we're going to get that is by having grams in the denominator. And so if grams is going in the denominator, it means that by default, kilograms has got to go in the numerator. And so now that we have our units, we're just going to fill in our corresponding numbers. So up in step one, we can see that kilograms was next to one, so that's going to be the same here. And then we also saw that grams was next to 1,000, so that's going to be the same here as well. All right, and so now we're ready to solve. And so looking at this, we get a couple of pieces of information. One, we know we can cancel out grams, right? We have this gram on the numerator, this gram on the denominator. We're multiplying, so we're allowed to cancel. This is great because we've gotten rid of our grams, and now our only unit left is kilograms, which is what we want to end up with anyway. And now, looking at our math, we can tell what we need to do either in our calculators or in our heads. And so that's going to be 12,400 divided by 1,000. And so that is going to equal 12.4 kilograms. And so that's it. Remember that as long as you have your number in your problem and whatever conversion ratio you need, any conversion problem can be solved just like this. I hope that you feel like you can convert from grams to kilograms now, and good luck with your studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.